the most, probably the most lasting impression that I had and have from after many decades of experience and association with Tamala Krishna Goswami was that, in my mind at least, he embodied the principle of Guru Nishtha, the devotion to one's spiritual master. It's something that he learned, no doubt, in the personal association of Srila Prabhupada, and it's also something that he emphasized consistently in his lectures and in his writings as well. To me, he embodied the very last word of the Shvetashvatara Upanishad, which is the famous verse, Yasya Devi Parabhaktir Yatha Devi Tatha Gurau Tasyaite Kadita Hyartha Prakashamti Paramahatmanaha, that for someone who has equal faith in the spiritual master and in Krishna, all the imports of the Vedic literatures are automatically revealed. He had a sense of Krishna consciousness that was just natural, and he was able to communicate that very well. But it also happened to be the very siddhanta of Vaishnava philosophy. I don't know of any way to glorify any godbrother or disciple of Srila Prabhupada in any way greater than to say that he embodied the very highest ideal of what it means to be a disciple. If one becomes a bona fide disciple, he actually becomes a bona fide guru, and that was him. He just embodied that principle so much. And all of his accomplishments and all of his considerable intelligence and determination and other qualities that we hear about him, I think they followed from this very basic, essential realization that he so naturally manifested in his very person. Every year that without his association, physical association, I feel this more and more and appreciate everything that he did for me personally and everything that he contributed to this movement. In some sense, I don't think it would be an exaggeration to say that he really contributed to the lion's share of what we know as ISKCON today by the grace of Srila Prabhupada and through the agency of his pure devotion to Srila Prabhupada.